Hi friends, I welcome you all. In this particular video walk of the panel data analysis using R, I would be showcasing to you how to script, your own script, I should say, in the coding panel of R. Now, these are the first three videos would be like the warm-up exercises and make your fingers comfortable, your hands. You should know where is what, because these are the some of the things that you will be using very frequently in your analysis using R itself. In the R environment, that's what I would say. Now, there are four panels, and I'm not supposed to give you the introduction to R, so I'm directly going ahead in order to know how to go ahead and code the data into the R sphere. Now, here you would see that yes, I have started off with the first one, wherein these are the very simple basic functions that you would be seeing yourself, that we will be using very frequently in the analysis. Like, for example, how to assign a number. So what are the various ways? So I have to showcase to you so that whichever you are comfortable with, you can do it. Now, for example, the first one, A is equals to 4. So you are supposed to know where A is, where equals to is, and 4. Now similarly, the next one, B equals to 5. Then what happens if I write A plus B? Okay, now A plus B, A space plus space B, what would be the answer? Without giving the space between A plus and B, what happens to it? Just check it out. Then similarly, if I keep A plus B within the brackets, I'm talking about the simple brackets as of now, then what will happen? A into B, that is asterisk B, what is going to happen? A cap B, which is, it is a shorter abbreviated form to say A raised to the power of 2. And similarly, B raised to the power of 2, and within brackets, A raised to the power of 2 divided by 2. R is very sensitive, and you should know that Bodmer's rules needs to be very carefully applied to it. So once you have keyed this particular, now I'm giving you the entire script towards the end of the video, or I can share it in the below the description, and you can take care of it directly, and this would be given to you. Now, this is the first method in which you are able to see. Now, after coding my entire script in the coding panel of the R software, then what will happen? You need to click at the end of each line. Okay, I have not, that's the reason why I have not used any hashtags out here. However, if I start using, then you will be able to understand. Bring the cursor towards the end of each line, and in your coding panel itself, you will be seeing the word run. Just click on run. Now, I'm not making you do the word, keep doing it, enter out here. Now, here, wherever the line is ending, whatever the numbers of lines are there, bring the cursor towards the end of each line and enter. Then you will see and focus on the output or the results pane of the R software. Now, here you will see the output is coming. For example, I have here A equals to 4. Now, while you're coding also, please make it sure that A, between A and equal to sign, there is a space. Now, similarly, between equal to and 4, there is space is again there. So, keep that in mind. Once you have keyed A space equal to sign space 4, then you run. Either you code the entire scripting together, and after that you can keep on running after each and every line. Now, running in the sense using the clicking on the run sign out here, and here keep an eye. For example, I have already copied my entire thing, and now you see what happens to it. Now, A equals to 4, run. Nothing has happened. I'm talking about focus now on the results or the output pane, which is present on your right hand side. Then click on B equals to 5 at the end of this line. Click on run. Can you see something? Nothing. It's just the code has come in directly. Now, next line, A plus B, run. It has given you the first result as 9. Reason? You have got the plus sign, which is the function, and it has given taken care of that particular operation, that is the addition operation, and it has given you the output. Similarly, check it out with the next one, A plus B, within the brackets, it's giving you 9. A into B, 20. A raised to the power of 2, So A is how much? 4, 4 raised to the power of 2, 16. Similarly, B raised to the power of 2, it will be how much it has given? 25. And then A raised to the power of 2, that is, it has given you how much? 4 into 4, 16. 16 divided by 2 gives you the answer as 8. So this is the first format that you need to understand, and I have showcased to you what is the difference between these two things. So let me come up with the other one in my next video walk. Till then, thanks and bye.